Good morning, children. Let's continue the chapter Deep Water, written by William Douglas. After several hours of drowning in the swimming pool, William Douglas walked back home. He was weak and trembling. He shook and cried when he lay on his bed. He couldn't eat that night. For days, a haunting fear was in his heart. He never went back to the pool. He feared water and avoided it whenever he could. A few years later, he came to know the waters of the cascades. He wanted to get into them, but whenever he did so, the terror that had seized him in the pool returned. His legs would become paralyzed. An icy horror would grab his heart. This handicap remained with him even as time passed. Wherever he went, the haunting fear of water followed him. It ruined his fishing trips. It deprived him of the joy of canoeing, boating, and swimming. He used every method he knew to overcome this fear. Finally, he decided to get an instructor and learn to swim. He went to a pool and practiced 5 days a week, an hour each day. The instructor put a belt around him. A rope attached to the belt went through a pulley on an overhead cable. He held on to the end of the rope. They went on this way for many weeks. On each trip across the pool, a bit of panic seized him. Each time the instructor relaxed his hold on the rope and the author went into water, some of the old terror returned and his legs froze. It was 3 months before the tension began to slack. Then the instructor taught him to put his face under water and exhale, and to raise his nose and inhale. He repeated this exercise hundreds of times. Very slowly, he shed some of the old panic and his head went under water. Then the instructor held him at the side of the pool and had him kick with his legs. He did this for weeks. Gradually, his legs relaxed. Thus, piece by piece, he built a swimmer. When he had perfected each piece, the instructor put them together into an integrated whole. He had started practicing in October, and in April, the trainer told him that he could swim. He asked the author to dive off and swim the length of the pool. He began with crawl stroke. When he swam alone in the pool, tiny remnants of the old terror would return. But now he could rebuke his terror. This went on till July. He was still not satisfied. So he went to Lake Wentworth in New Hampshire. There he dived off a dock at Trix Island. He swam 2 miles across the lake to Stamp Act Island. He swam the crawl, breaststroke, side stroke, and backstroke. The terror returned only once. When he was in the middle of the lake, he put his face under and saw nothing but bottomless water. He asked terror what it could do to him, and it fled away. Some doubt still remained. He tried swimming in so many other water bodies. Once he went to Warm Lake, dived into it, and swam across to the other shore and back. He shouted with joy, and Gilbert Peak returned the echo. He had conquered his fear of water. This experience had a deeper meaning for him. Only those who have known stark terror and conquered it can appreciate it. In death, there is peace. There is terror only in the fear of death. Roosevelt knew it, he said. All we have to fear is fear itself. Douglas had experienced both the sensation of dying and the terror that fear of it can produce. The will to live somehow grew in intensity. At last, Douglas felt liberated. He was free to walk the trails and climb the peaks and ignore fear. This chapter, it's over. Let's continue with the next chapter tomorrow. Thank you.